thank you for this opportunity that you have granted us as Obanda Primary School. We are very grateful for the progress that has been made in this school. The classroom where we are standing now is one of those classes that we were able to build as the community jointly with our friends. We are very, very grateful for the work that has been done in this place. This particular block was condemned in 2018 by the Ministry of Health. And when we came in June 2019, it was our first item to do because our children had nowhere to attend classes. They were doing it under the trees. So if you can see the building that was there before, those who came here around November 2019, if they come back today, they will actually find this new building, which is a standard building. The classes are standard, even as you can see this one. It is spacious enough, and it has been done by the effort of friends of Obanda, the community around, and our friends all over. So we are very, very grateful for what has been done, and we want to appeal to those that have been supporting Obanda Primary School that the shilling that you gave in one of our many fundraisers did not actually go to vain. Today, the children have a place that they can actually come and learn, and we want to continue upgrading this school and to ensure that by the time our term comes to an end, the facilities of this school will actually be near par many other schools that children would actually feel comfortable enough to pursue their learning.
Our main concern now goes to the latrines that the children are using. Just as I quoted the population, the enrollment of the school, we have 210 boys, and we should be having 30 boys per pit latrine, which means that we need 7 pit latrines, that is 7 doors. And the girls, we are having 169. The girls are a bit special sex, and they use 525 of them use one pit latrine, meaning that 169 girls, they should also be having 7 pit latrines. So in total we need 14 pit latrines, but out of all these we only have we only have 3 available for the girls and 2 available for the boys, making it a total of 5, which means that we lack 9 pit latrines.
On behalf of the BOM, St. Agnes Obanda Primary School, we are very grateful for the support that we have received the 2.5 years that we have been part of the BOM for this school. The work that has happened in this school could not have gone without the support from everyone. And we just want to say a big, big thank you to all those who have funded our projects. Whenever we have appealed for support, there are many friends who have come through for us. Just as you have heard the needs of the school, as the head teacher has actually explained, we know that the government is solely responsible for education in the public sector, but we are also alive to the fact that the government is not able to provide every need to our children in the public schools, more so in a school that is in a rural setup like this one, where most parents or guardians are not having a very good economic livelihood. Many of our pupils are actually dependent on their grandparents. Most of them, they don't have like their parents because of what happened in this area, the HIV scourge. Many of these grandparents, they are also not having a very good livelihood. So unlike schools that are in the city or in the towns, this school has actually made leaps and bounds as a result of well wishers. And I also want to recognize the alumni who have also come through for this school. One of them is our patron currently, Dr. Victor Oria, whose support has been so immense together with his friends in taking this school far. We have a group that calls itself Obanda Development CBO, and part of them are with me here. They also happen to have children in this school or relatives in this school. So they continue playing a very key role in supporting this school in this community. We are not only proud of the building that we are seeing behind us. We are very proud of our pupils that have continued to excel in their KCPE exams. And as we speak now, courtesy of the support that we have provided for this school, we are happy to report that one of the daughters of this place, Irene, is actually undertaking a bachelor's education in Meru University, second year. We have one of the children that we supported who sat his KCPE last year, Peter, and he got admitted this year in Daystar University, and he will continue studying actuarial. We have another daughter who also did her KCSE last year, and she will be pursuing her civil engineering. And these are the stories that we really want to hear. Most of these kids had lost hope. They were academically performing, but when they got their results, there were nobody, there were no people who could actually come through for them. And as a result of this group, the BOM, well wishers and our friends, we were able to take them through secondary education. Right now we have nearly 15 pupils that are scattered in secondary schools courtesy of the bursary kitty that we came up with. We know that we have so many people that are supporting children, like the CDF, they support children. We have banks that support children. But what people miss out, the competition for those support is so high because the need is overwhelming. And you will find like the cutoff mark to support those ones are like 370 and above. So most of our children, they perform very well. And you find that they have hit, like last year we had our top candidate, Stanton, who had scored 395 marks. But because of the competition, he was not able to even get the CDF support. And out of our bursary, we were able to even give 25,000 just to enable Stanton to join Kabianga High School, one of the very performing schools around. And this really gives a lot of hope to many children. We were equally able to support the top girl to also join Tudiburo Secondary School. And these things really make us very happy because when you come through for an orphan, when you come through for a vulnerable kid, perhaps this may not be your own child, but as you do that, even God is blessing you in leaps and bounds.
Thank you.